speaks to a profound sickness in the soul of American society. All of you hated capitalism, right? That was why you came out. You couldn't deal with capitalism, couldn't deal with the realities of capitalism. But it turns out that these banks, actually, they're the ones that are afraid of capitalism. They're afraid of real prices. And capitalism, obviously, for all its problems, it does have real capitalism. True free market has some genuine democratic qualities. In true capitalism, $2 in a poor man's pocket is always worth $1, more than $1 in a rich man's pocket, right? That's always true. But what the system that they contrived to organize was different. This was a whole bunch of rich guys who kept their hands over their pockets and said, trust us, we've got $3 in there. And that's what they did. They rigged the game so that no matter what happens, they always win. And we have a word for this. When people who are supposed to be competing stop competing and they start cooperating. We have a word for it when people are afraid of democracy, they're afraid of free competition, when they get together and they rig the game so that they always win and we always lose. And the word for that is oligarchy. And that's the situation that we're in right now. And it's much worse than we thought. Forget about the LIBOR scandal, forget about all this news stuff. Think about what happened before 2008 with the mortgage-backed security scandal. What was that scandal all about? It was about big banks, big companies, taking toxic, worthless mortgage-backed securities and selling it to, among other people, state pension funds. So you had ordinary working people who worked hard jobs, they were toll collectors or cops or firemen, their whole lives, they saved up money, and then in the end, a bank comes in and they sell them a bunch of bonds that they know are going to blow up in a couple of years because they know how those bonds were made. That's stealing the life savings of old ladies and old men. And it wasn't just, we'd understand if a couple of random diabolical sociopathic criminals, a couple of Bernie Madoff types had done this. We would understand that because genetic accidents happen. You're never going to get everybody to fall in line. But this wasn't that. This was systemic. This was everybody on Wall Street. It was 10, 20,000 college-educated professionals openly, willingly doing this and not really having a second thought about it.